Good afternoon. Thank you so much for inviting me to participate in this event. I am speaking from Bologna, Italy, on day 20 of confinement, lockdown. So the question of critical theory in a time of pandemic is particularly close to me right now. I am confined at home and I try to push critical theory. My question is which should be the main point of view that we take on the pandemic? As you all know, the question of control has been at the center of many debates over the last weeks. Control in a biopolitical mode and well-known theorists have proposed kind of apocalyptic views of the state of exception that is connected to the management of the pandemic. Well, to be honest, I am convinced that control is not the most effective point of view on the pandemic. And in my own writings on coronavirus, I have attempted to open a different angle. I think that we should focus on the flows that the pandemic exposes in our political, social and economic system, as well as in our relation with nature, with the environment. And from this point of view, what emerges at first sight is fragility, precarity in a very expanded sense. Fragility, precarity also of what we have been calling over the last decade the common. I think that from this point of view, kind of feminist take on the question of coronavirus is really necessary. Feminist reflections upon precarity and upon care are crucial for us today. And they are crucial also regarding the common. Of course, when I speak of the common with respect to the pandemic, what I have in mind is first of all health. Health is a constitutive aspect of the common. And we are experiencing these days the fragility, the precarity of health and health systems. From this point of view, the question of the care of the common is really crucial, I repeat. And public health is indeed a crucial stake in the management of the pandemic. My talk bears the title A Politics of Struggles, and let me say that public health is a first field of struggle that emerges in the pandemic and that I would like to emphasize. I'm thinking first of all of the workers that are employed in hospitals, more generally in health systems. But I am thinking of the health system as such, as a kind of common good whose strategic relevance emerges in the crisis. We all know that also in continental Europe there have been over the last decade dramatic cuts to health systems. Maybe we can bet that after the current crisis it will be more difficult to propose further cuts. Maybe the neoliberal rhetoric of public-private management, the neoliberal processes of privatization of health systems will be questioned after the end of the pandemic. Needless to say, as I was saying, this is a field of struggle. We have no guarantees. And from this point of view, the engagement, the activism of health workers is crucially important. We are experiencing in these days a kind of double crisis, the pandemic and the economic crisis. Capitalism is currently in a deep crisis. Logistical conduits that are so important for contemporary capitalism seem obstructed. We are confronted with a crisis of capitalism that is significantly different from the one we experienced in 2007-2008. This is not a crisis that has its origin in the financial markets. The financial markets are compelled to take stock of a crisis that originated somewhere else. I'm not imagining a collapse of capitalism. Capitalism will continue to exist also after the pandemic. No doubt regarding that. But capitalism will not be the same as before. And I think that the question of public health points to a crucial fault line for the development of capitalism after the crisis. We are confronted today with a line that unites Johnson, Trump, Bolsonaro. And this is a line that emphasizes a kind of Malthusian policies in the crisis, that recommends a kind of open social Darwinism. How can we resist to such positions? Needless to say, the clash surrounding the present and the future of public health is crucially important from this point of view. So, public health is a first important field of struggle that emerges in the current crisis. But there are several other fields of struggle that is worth mentioning. Referring basically to the Italian experience, I could speak of the many strikes of factory workers who refused to continue to work, to subordinate their life to the imperative of profit. And the mobilization of factory workers has kind of reopened a space for unionism. There are currently campaigns for a quarantine income, for instance, which is a kind of social unionism that stresses the needs of precarious and flexible workers. So this is another important field of struggle that has emerged in the crisis. But then think of care labor, of a care labor that continues to be disproportionately attributed to women. Also from this point of view, in a time of pandemic, in a time of lockdown, we can imagine the intensity of struggles that traverse households and raise the question of a redistribution of care labor. We had in Italy spectacular uprisings in prisons in the last weeks. And And these uprisings have been highly paid. Dozens of inmates died during the uprisings. But nevertheless, the uprisings were able to shed light once again on the world of prisons, that had become a kind of black hole over the last years. And then you have also mobilizations, struggles of migrants in detention. Repatriation is currently blocked because of the virus. And so there are campaigns for the closure of detention centers in this moment in Italy. I could easily go on and mention other fields of struggle, but I hope I gave at least the idea of a very rich and lively development of actual and potential struggles in the framework of the pandemic. In a way, in a classical way, the crisis, the emergence, allows to shed light on trends that are also characteristic of the quote and unquote normality. Let me conclude by saying that the politics of struggles that I have quickly sketched opens an angle also on the question of control that I was mentioning at the beginning. Needless to say, current measures to confront the pandemic bear the risk of an extension and further entrenchment of social control, of authoritarianism. We have to be aware of this risk. But what I think is that social struggles revolving around the care of the common are the most effective antidote against this extension of social control and authoritarianism. So, from my point of view, the pandemic, the management of the pandemic as a whole, is a field of struggle. And the struggle is open. It depends on all of us, which will be the outcome, which will be the world.